Hey there, everybody. It's me, Jill McKay, coming to you from my studio in Fort Collins, Colorado. And today is Micro Mosaic Kit Tutorial Day. I'm pretty excited. And all the kits are ready to go. I'm waiting, and it's coming tomorrow, from the pendants that I had bought went out of stock. And I was like, but wait. They're like, oh, it won't be back in stock till the 24th of November. And I'm like, that can't be possible. Maybe you could find some for me in the warehouse. And the next day they called back and said, oh, good news. They showed up early. And I was like, thank goodness, because far more people ordered this kit. And thank you for doing so than I anticipated, truly. I thought maybe 15. And the thing I want you to know is that that was the first micro mosaic I have ever tried. And I am not doing it the traditional way. So there are many, many videos out there if you wish to do it a traditional way. And also, we're not going to be finishing it the traditional way because I don't have any lapidary equipment to grind it down off the same surface. So I'll show you how we're going to handle that when we get going here. So thank you for being here. Say hello. If you have questions along the way, please say so. And I'll try to look up once in a while at the comments, but if I miss it, I certainly will go back today for sure and go through all the comments. Know that I'm glad you're here. Okay, let me switch over to my hands. Okay, so this is what your micro mosaic pre-cut. So I pre-cut all the leaves, the flowers, the daisy petals, but it did not pre-cut the green, and you may find some other little colors in there. So let's open our tube up. This is exactly what you're going to get. And JB Welding, these are my tweezers, but your tweezers look like this. So they're very nice stainless steel. You'll be getting one of these. And off we go. So I loved putting it in a little tube. I thought that would be pretty happy. So I'm just going to get my tweezers here and get things in different piles. So my leaves. And the order came in from Italy, and a lot of it was different than my first order, and I ordered the exact same thing. So some things weren't as big. Some of the flowers that came were just a lighter blue. The ones that I used in my original sample all had a clear yellow center with a red stripe around it. But what was really different was the orange petals. So this is what we're working with, okay? Get everything squared away. My flowers in one place, my petals in another, and my leaves in another. So I gave you extra of everything, and I want to urge you to be creative with your kit, okay? You might want to play around and place things in here and get a different view than mine. This was my original one. And I'll tell you how I finished it. I finished this with a two-part epoxy. That is not coming in your kit. It is super inexpensive and easy to find. I got mine at the grocery store, but you'll get more choices if you buy them at a hardware store. And I bought a crystal clear one. It makes it a little glossy, but it is no longer sharp. Hey everyone, welcome. So the first thing we're going to do is I am going to take, and you can put gloves on for this if you want, I'm not going to, and you're just going to do one part, this, which is the hardener, and I'm squeezing pretty hard. Put the lid back on. Set that aside. And this is the darker part. It's like a steel color. So to open them, you just take and puncture it and then turn it around. So I'm going to put out as close as I can get to the same amount. Looks good to me. Hey, Cher, welcome. Great name. Okay, so I'm going to use one end of this for the epoxy resin that will hold the filati in place. And then I'm going to wipe it off at the end, and then I'm going to use the other end when I go to do my clear two-part epoxy to blend it all together. So I'm just going to mix now, very simply. There's a tiny bit of smell that I'm noticing right now. It's not overwhelming, but you might want to do this part in a ventilated area. Now this epoxy, they make many different kinds, this particular JB Weld. This is a 4 to 6 setup time. So I like that because if I'm starting and something happens, I can go back through. So if you're not sure how much time that you're going to have, you want to just work a little bit at a time. As you fill the whole thing up, well, you could come back within the 4-hour time frame. Okay? So, then you can use your stick, but I personally, I'm going to wipe this off here. And then I'm going to wipe my stick off, like I said, a paper towel, set that aside. I obviously have all kinds of tools here in the studio. I'm going to be using this one that's got a little head on it. I used to sell these sculpture tools, but we sold out and they didn't really sell, so I'm not selling them anymore. But I would use a toothpick or a matchstick, a wooden matchstick, to put your epoxy in. So I'm just going to pick some up and then I'm going to just begin to move it around in my bezel. Okay, you can do your best to keep this off the edges of your bezel. Okay, super easy. And I am barely coating the base. I guess it's not barely, but I'm just smoothing it along. I don't want to see any more of the bottom of this bezel, okay? It's not hard to do. So I just use those two little dabs is all I use. You're going to have lots left over. So pretty soon I'm going to be putting up lots more bezels. So, okay, I'm just trying to smooth it out. Make sure it's all along the edges. And we have some nice even. Okay, so now I'm going to wipe this off. And I notice, if you look closely, I can see that I got a little bit on that edge right there. So right this moment, I'm going to stop and get rid of that. I don't want that showing. Okay, pretty simple. All right, I'm gonna set this aside. Got some on my fingernail too. Let's get that off. All right, so that was easy, right? Hey, Becky. Hey, Em, thank you for being here. My favorite one, my favorite of these are the little leaves because they're like different colors. So, but that's what we're going to start with anyways. So I'm going to pick up a leaf and I want the white tips of the leaves facing upward, okay? And I mean up towards the top. You could do it differently. This is just how I did it, so. There's the little, whoop, come on camera, the white tip. And these are a little smaller than the ones that I originally had ordered. So I'm just putting it in. I'm trying to make sure it's standing upright, okay? Put in my next one. I tried to cut these as evenly as possible for you. I'm just moving my pendant around so I can hold it at the same time. These things move around a little bit. It's not super tacky. The epoxy is not really, like, doesn't hold it super well in the beginning. So it will move around on you, okay? I'm trying to pick up. Oop, I just flung it away from myself, okay? There we go. Getting them in the tweezers is probably the trickiest part because I want to be able to see it. There we go. Can you see well enough? Should I zoom in some? I should zoom in. There we go. Whoa, that's in. All right. So now I'm going to place this third one. And once you get them in place, so I'm taking these two outside leaves, and I want them kind of turning outwards, whereas the center leaf, I kind of want it going straight up. I'm going to take another. I'm going to place him like feathers lay. So I'm putting the bottom tip in between these two leaves, okay? These are handmade filati, which is, it's like rod, but it's not rod. They're canes. Oh, I just keep, maybe I should use the wider. It's cane that have been made especially for micro mosaics. And I ordered it and bought it. Oops, I was about to put my white part down instead of up. Okay. Once again, I'm putting it right in between those. So I think I want one more. So in my original one, you'll see that I have five, but this filati was much bigger. I'm actually going to send a message about receiving inconsistency. I was very surprised how all the rods I received, not rods, the filati was very, they were all very different sizes. Okay. Keep this guy going straight up. Try and sneak another one in there. There we go. I like how that looks. Okay, let's see if I can show you close up. Okay. It's just like little bushes. Little bushes in the front of our flowers. And now, let's put in, I'm going to take and put in a yellow flower, and these have stems in them. Now, I tried to get I had some of the original flowers, petals, as they call these. This is petal filati. I tried to get some of these in each kit, but I know I didn't get it in all kits. But I had one left laying here on my table. So I'm going to go ahead and place him between those top leaves right there. But the filati that we got has a little brown stem, an orange center, and a beautiful yellow surrounding. So right now I'm going to move on to some little blue flowers. So I just put one on there, and I'm going to, as I go, I'm going to move things around so I can get them in as tight as possible, okay? And I vary the sizes and where I'm placing them. I just popped out. Oh, I don't like when you get them tipped over in the, oh, good, it didn't ruin it. I'm gonna try and stand him up. There we go, cool. Go in a little more. Yay, that's even better. Okay, wipe my tweezers off every once in a while. I'm going to try the tweezers that I sent you guys. Maybe those are even better. Ooh, they do work better. Nice. Okay, I'm just going to place some flowers in. And now, you each got one long piece. And what you want to do, I'm going to show you how to. So, here's a really long piece, but I'm just going to measure, eyeball it where I want it, which is right about here. And all I'm using to, where did they go? Here they are, is a pair of flat nose or chain nose pliers. I'm going to put it right where I want it to be. And then I'm going to bring my pliers up towards me. And you heard that little snap? Super easy. Now, there are some of the rods that are thicker like this, but it's still basically the same Okay. It's just an easy snap. And if you get a really thick piece of filati, then you're going to want, where did it go? You're going to want to use a triangular shaped diamond tipped. This is a jeweler's file. But I want to tell you, because this is how they do it traditionally. They get it on one of these edges, and then they just make a little groove. Oop, I'm off camera. Forgot I'm zoomed in. They make a little groove, and you see the little scratch. It's really, that's exactly where it will break then, because you have broken the molecules, okay? But you shouldn't need to use this. This is why I did not include one in your kit, and your kit would have been far more expensive because that is a. So I'm going to try and get this in. Set it in there. And I'm going to take my tweezers because I see that I got a little bit of that glue on top of my filati. I don't know how I did that, but I don't want it there. You can even try and just take a piece of tissue and make sure you have the folded side facing down and just gently wipe it off. But it's not coming all the way off, but I'm still pleased with it. Now I'm going to try and make mine a little not just perfectly centered because your eye likes to look more closely, excuse me, at things that are not perfectly centered. Okay. And then I'm just going to put in another daisy petal, okay? And I want the stem and orange end to be down. Just like that. Okay. And my last one, and you can put in as many of these as you like. You have extra. I just wanted a hint of the yellow. So I'm just going to put one more up here on the top. Coming and move it around because I want the bottom of it coming off that green like it's coming right off. Now you're going to have to readjust that one. See how pretty that is already? I have glasses on. Yes, thank you, Barbara. Yep, that's what it is scoring. So with the file, that's how they do it though. So now I am just going to put some more flowers in. I tried to give you different sizes so you could put them in different places. It's just really kind of fun, I have to tell you. I drop them in and then move them around. I'm always readjusting this green guy here, the long green stem, because I want him to be standing up straight. Okay, some more flowers in. It's fun. Let's get a bigger one. Putting them in one at a time. Getting in as many as I can. Super sweet. And then moving them around a little. Oh, Oops, he went in sideways. Poo. I'm going to pick him up end to end and then try to check him out and see if he's got goop on his front. And he does, so I'm just going to take him and wipe him off just like this to get the goop off so he's still purdy. And then try it again. Back to these tweezers. Yay. Just moving it around. It's very cute. I need a small one. Fill in. Oh no, he just went flying off and he was the last really small one. Shoot. Well, let's see if this guy will fit in. We can move things around if we need to. Oh, he did. Oh, lovely. Fabulous. Okay, I'm going to move this back and try and get in one more flower above the petal, yellow petal. Let's get him in there. There. So, I've got flowers in. So, and there's lots of this left over. So now, I am going to take and break off some, whoop, this guy, I just noticed this leaf really went in a unique position there. I'm going to straighten him out some, okay? All right. So it's sweet. It's very sweet. So I'm going to take now some of my green here, and I'm going to just make some small pieces. Ooh, that one. So I clicked down. For some reason, when I move away from myself, I use more force. You do not want to hold this glass very tight. You just want to... And I'm moving it up into the jaw a little bit. I'm just making some different sizes. So I have lots to work with. Little ones. Big ones. Very easy to do. I also tried to put some blues or browns or beiges, some, you know, at least one other color. Well, this one is super thin. I'm just going to take and break off little pieces of this. Maybe a little bit of blue. And we'll just fill in around the flowers as best we can. It's super easy. I love the look too. And it's just really different. So if it's okay with you guys, I'm going to, I don't know. Oops, I broke that one. Sometimes it splits a little bit. Sometimes it doesn't. Anyways, we got lots of little pieces now. Okay, so I'm going to kind of pull these over to the side. And I also pre-cut some others. So you get plenty of green for real. So I think I'm going to go back. I'm going to pick up a little piece of flutty. This is called flat flutty. Okay, look how, whoa, it's very small. So I'm just going to start filling in the areas. Sorry, you see my hands shaking. The areas around the flowers. I really want to be holding them from the top. So I can place them into the spaces that I see that need filling. And if you don't want to, I did not ever finish filling all the spaces in this one. As you can see, I started and then and never finished. But I wanted to fill in this one in case that's what you would like to do. But I kind of like how it looks dark in the back. And you could also, you could take and grout this, though I didn't want to do that because the sizes are different. I did not want to have to clean it. That's the worst part about grouting is cleaning. So I'm just gonna try and keep filling in here. But really, I actually like it. Oh, I thought that was a spot. It is not, but this is. I kind of want these to have one end heading towards the main green piece. See if I can accomplish this. And then the other end heading out in a branching fashion like that. Because that's what they look like in real life. Yes. So, but it also could just be background greenery. So if you want to fill all the spaces, just put green around them. Let's see if we can add a little blue, what that looks like. Hey, Gwen, you darling woman, you. Glad you're here. The working time, Emily, is, so this is the JB Weld, and you have 4 to 6 hours. So they do make one that sets up in minutes, but obviously, I liked the blue in there. I'm going to go back through every kit and make sure I put blue in every one because that I really liked. Okay. Maybe that's blue sky behind there. Ooh, that looks nice. I like that a lot. Very good. So I just set it on my fingers because I want to get it from the top. And of course, after I say that, I make it look really hard. Yeah. I really like the way this blue looks. Where can I put some more? Right here. Maybe. So cute. Excuse me. Got another green one here. It's really very sweet. I'm going to take a blue one up here at the top, where it appears there is space. I think I got this. I had that one by the side, not the top. So I'm going to follow my own technique here and just pick that up and then put it in. Wipe off my tips. I can see that I have a little bit of the, you know, when you're putting it in, sometimes I'm going to try and make this one a little bit smaller. You know what? I'm going to try something. I don't think I'll use Mitronix, but I'm going to use my wire cutters and see if we can make work perfectly. Smaller cuts with your wire cutters. Yay. Okay. I'm off camera, sorry guys. Just forget it's really zoomed in. So I'm gonna cut another one. And really try. So I've got my little piece, I've got my wire cutters. And I popped off there. But that works, so voila. This is fun. It really is. Let's see if I'm really liking it. Oops. It's not a very straight piece, but this one is. Okay. Where did I see that space? Maybe it was right here. Oop, it's sticking to my tweezers. There we go. Look how cute. It's so fun. It's so simple. Let's see. Small piece. And sometimes, so, you know, you want to turn it so you do have the side instead of the top. And that way, you can even have a smaller piece. I'm going to try and fit this one in here, though there's not much space at all. That is looking so cute. I really like the blue. Oh, man. Very happy. I'm going to try and cut a couple more little pieces. I'm facing, oops, so that one didn't work so well. That maybe the piece was too small to cut. Too much pressure. Ooh, that worked. Good, I got a really little one. Yay! I really want something right there. And I think there's a space here. I could get him in there. Yes. Cool. Well, this is very sweet. The one piece that's bothering me is this one right here, because it's going horizontal. Nothing else is horizontal. So I'm going to, it makes my, draws my eye to it. So I'm just going to try and turn it. Oh, I got it all messy. So now I can find a new piece and get him in there. He's horizontal again. Take my tweezers and try and manipulate it so it's there. That's better. And then look, and now I have room for another green one. Take and put in another green one. I hope. Well, now that's horizontal again, so that looks better though to me. So definitely does. My eye, it is, this is super fun. So I think I can fit something else right in there. Find me a piece. Let's see here. Want a pretty small piece. And I'm going to stand this on its edge so it's just a little shorter. Let's see if I can get him in there. Maybe not. Sometimes I'm going to try and take this little broken piece here just to fill in that spot. Come on, buddy. Get in there. He's not cooperating. Maybe that space just isn't quite what I think it is. Must not be. That dark blue is actually filling up that space. I don't think we're going to get anything else in there. Okay, we tried. All right. One more up here. Okay. Oh, good. I got a blue one in there. Cool. I want to have him facing the different direction. There we go. There. So cute. Very happy. Break up some more blue into, I'm actually, this is shattering a little, which is just fine for me right this second, because I can use these really little pieces to fill in where I want them to go. Oop. Come back. Oh, for heaven's sakes, where'd he go? I don't see him. We'll use this guy. Set him in there. Well, I'm telling you, that one just disappeared into thin air, honest to Pete. What in the world? Where could it have gone? There we go. That looks pretty cute. Still don't like these guys right here. So if I'm going to put some space between them, it makes me feel better. For some reason, it looks more natural that way. Okay. Cool. Now, I'm going to zoom back out a little. Oop, wrong way. Here we go. And I am going to go ahead and clear. Sorry, I'm using a really old beat mat because this glass is going to get into it. It's clearing off, clearing that off. Now, you would want to let this sit overnight. before you do the step I'm about to show you, okay? But I'm absolutely pleased with, they're a little different, but I like them both. You know, I think they're very sweet. So I'm definitely going to be making more, and I did buy a lot of Filati. A lot. Flower Filati, petal Filati, leaf Filati, flat Filati. So I am going to show you how I finished this one. Now, it is rough, guys, okay? I can tell you that it is rough unless you do this step. But there's no finding two-part epoxy. And the kind of epoxy I'm talking about is this. Let me get it open here. It's just very simple. It's the kind that comes and you just push and it puts out the right amount. So you don't have to do like you did with the JB Weld. So I'm just going to push here. But don't buy Best Buy because the cap would not go back on. So I'm using, you see it coming out there? I'm using more than I need to, but I'm just going to, when you stop, you want to pull back on the plunger so it quits coming out. Now, this one doesn't have a top, so I'm using tape. So I'm going to grab the tape real quick so I can use this again. Thank you for waiting. Now, we're going to use the other end of our stir stick to mix these two together. And you just read the manufacturer's instruction. Thank you for your compliments, everyone. And like I said, if you're coming in the middle of this broadcast, I am not doing this in a traditional fashion. I am doing it as a layman and for fun. And it really is fun. So I'm just going to keep mixing. Again, this has a little bit of a smell, but you want to buy the clearest looking one. But make sure and look at the top. See if it's got a good cap. Because, boy, this one did not. Okay, that should be plenty well mixed. I'm going to wipe my stick off, even though I won't need it again. Now, I am going to ruin a paintbrush of my choosing. And the one that I'm choosing, it's a little bit long. In fact, let me see if I have a different one. Because the one I was using before already set up. Oh, I like this one. I'm going to use this one. I buy cheap brushes all the time because I ruin all of them. I mean, even if you're just painting with paint, they still, you know, once the bristles are out of line, I'm going to have to zoom back in again. So let us come back so you can see. Whoa, too close. Better. All right, so now I'm really going to avoid those little air bubbles here. And I'm just going to pick up, if you can see it that much. And I'm really just going to paint the surface. I'm also trying to make sure that it goes down in between, but you don't want to go over the edge. So I'm just kind of moving it around here. Spooging is what the technical term is. And having it go down into those open spaces. This will also secure it. So I'm going along the edge here. I'm going to wipe it off though pretty quickly because it will... This stuff does set up in minutes. So if you get it on the edge, you'll want to stop and get it off right away, okay? But basically, I am just taking it and going over the edges of all these pieces and down in the holes. I tried to cut the pieces as evenly as possible, but obviously it's impossible to get all of them covered. I hope nobody from Italy that knows how to make micro mosaics ever sees this video, because they might go, "What is she doing?" But this works for me. I am happy with it, so. And if you see that it's like pooling, like right here, I can see it's pooling a little bit. So I'm just going to bring my brush through there and bring it down. Because I really just am trying to cover the surface so it's not sharp. So it is no longer sharp, okay? Oop, got a little stringer there, and I see that I got a little tiny bit right on the edge here. So I'm going to stop and clean that off because I don't want air. That to be messed up. Hey Melanie, welcome. Making a little micro mosaic. Super fun. Ooh, another stringer. Gotta watch out for stringers as it starts to set up. Okay. And it is kicking off pretty hard, so I'm gonna have to get moving here. Or I'll just mix some more, so I don't want to have to move too quickly. And it is really going fast right now, so I'm going to stop and make some more up. Because, wow, the first time I did this, it did not set up so quickly. I think I mixed it too long, so I'm not going to mix as long. Excuse me, I'm getting out some more glue. And I'm not going to mix it as long. Okay, where did my stir stick go? I'm just going to mix it for a second here because, wow, that just really kicked off. So these things don't dry. It's a chemical reaction. All right. I'm going to have to find a different brush now because this one is toast. Okay, let me find a different brush real quick. This one, oh yeah, that's so much better. Okay, now I can finish doing the tops far more easily. That could have been a disaster. Honestly, get some down in there along the edge. Really, just making sure it's coated. And I'm pretty sure I have gotten every little bit coated. And once you have it coated, you want to stop, because if it starts kicking off, then when you drag your brush through it, it looks it leaves a texture. We don't want any texture, because we don't want to interfere with the view of the glass. So I am going to stop there and that will dry. And if you set it in the sun, not dry, it will set up very quickly and super fun. Whoa, I'm coming back up to talk to you, so. Oh, that was fun. Really, really sweet. So that will dry or set up in about 5 minutes, and I could actually wear it. A full cure, I think, would be in a couple hours, just for the clear coat that we did just that. But what it allows you to do is to run your fingers over it without any harm of scratching yourself, because sometimes the glass is sharp. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. I would like to say that the time when I put up the pre-order for this kit, I still had not decided how I was going to finish it. So the fact that I used this two-part epoxy was not in the list of things you'll need. So I apologize for that you're going to have to get one more thing, so, and a paintbrush. But you'll get more glass than you need, and Donna comes home today. Oh no, tomorrow. And I'm starting to ship them out now, so post office isn't open today. Oh, you're very welcome. And I will be back on Wednesday with yet another project for you. I hope you enjoyed this one. I liked it because it was so different. All right. Thank you kindly. Appreciate you. I appreciate your orders. I appreciate your attention. And thank you for tuning in. Please be kind to others. Be really good to yourself. All right. Mwah. Love you guys. Take care.